wide receiver. Let's turn our attention to the last group, the group we haven't gotten to quite yet, and that's PJ Fleck and the Minnesota Golden Gophers. Here's a look at this class, which is pretty darn good. Basically, as good a class as Minnesota has brought in the past decade. We talked with PJ Fleck about this group back on the first signing day.
Recruiting's all down, comes down to really the people that you trust. This is about the perfect fit. I've said for years, I'm not for everybody. I'm not sure who is for everybody, and nor does anyone want to be for everybody, right? But when you have the right fit and you have coaches telling you this guy would be perfect for you, especially with people that you trust, I think that's where you can take the next step with the program. And that's what we're working to do, is just take the next right step from this year 4 going into 5 and so on and so forth.
You know, over the years, as you and I have talked on signing day, you've told me one year you leaned on the offensive line, one year you leaned on defense. Where did you feel this year's class was leaning?
Well, you'd like to be spread out as much as you can, and you want to get to the point where you're spread out every single year and you've got 25, 26 players, you know, 2-3 at every position, and everybody's happy. That's not how it necessarily works. Remember, when we first got here, we had 4 offensive linemen on the entire team. So there's a lot of things that shift and move when you're only allowed to bring in 25 per year. But this year we talked about, we wanted to go everywhere we possibly could to go find some of the best D linemen in the country. And I think that's one of our focuses, was the defense of line. And we went from West Coast all the way to East Coast, all the way from Washington to Florida and Minnesota and Indiana and other places in between to find some of the best defensive linemen we could find that were a perfect fit for us. And we couldn't be more excited about that position.
You know, in the past, PJ has brought in some big offensive linemen.
Literally.
And we mean big, like 360 and 400 pounds in some of the guys. Alan, there's a guy he's bringing in on offensive line this year. Not quite that big, but still pretty impressive.
Yeah, Siah Mapakatolo, who was committed to USC for a long time, decommitted, looked like he might stay out west. BYU was one of the programs involved, but Minnesota quickly rose up his list, and he's got a lot of potential here. 6'5", 280 pounds. You know, we like guys that size who are athletic enough to play other sports. This guy was a rugby player. So Minnesota, I thought, late in this class, did a great job of filling needs and were able to leave the Midwest to do so. They went out west to get him. They went out west to get Jacob Schuster. They went down south to pick up another defensive tackle. So they were able to recruit outside of the footprint in order to find some of these big guys around the country.
Yeah, and I think part of it is PJ's unique personality, right? I mean, he isn't for everybody. I mean, he is certainly unique, and so he has to have a bigger footprint. The only thing that PJ can't control is what the rest of the West is doing. I mean, when he first came, the competition in the West recruiting wasn't what it is right now. The whole West division of the Big Ten has gotten so much better in recruiting that it's actually going to be harder for PJ to continue to out-recruit some of the guys in the West. He's unique. He's a very good recruiter, and he just contributes to what we're seeing, and that's an upward trend in the quality of recruits that the West Division is signing.
Well, it was kind of easy for him to out-recruit the other guys because they weren't recruiting at the level that he was recruiting. So I think he'll be able to elevate his recruiting as well, just as the competition has. But this is also going to be another program that I think is going to dive into the transfer portal to get back to where they were 2 years ago when they had an unbelievable season. And once you have a taste of that, you then kind of look at your team and you try to figure out, okay, well, where do we have a hole? Where can we shore up a position? And now with the transfer portal, you're able to go out and find those players that you can plug in that are ready to go, that can buy into your system from day one and can also help develop some of that young talent behind them. So I expect him to go out and get some key people to help him as he continues to try to go out and win a championship here in the Big Ten.
So